It's been a few days since I've actually played, so I'm gonna have to kind of catch up. And I believe that we were creating, so we got a hook going on the son of our half brother that we killed. So we murdered our half brother, and this is his son. So we're just trying to get a hook on him. So nobody's actually formed Denmark yet, but it will form down here somewhere. So I guess it's going to be a case of who ends up getting that and who ends up becoming the king. Now, we have got quite a few daughters now. We have this girl who is 22, so she could be married off. And we've got this 14-year-old girl here. She has got an incredible intrigue stat, so possible spy master when she turns 16. And then the other girls are like 11 and below. So I don't think we have to worry about them too much yet, but you know, it's always good to have them there ready to marry off if needed. So I think the first thing we need to look at is Bjorn now is 65, so he hasn't got many days left. So his son's going to be taking over shortly, I would assume. So I'm thinking what might be the best thing to do here is to actually marry our daughter off to him. Now, I think that she's a little bit too old because obviously we want to give them the best chance that they have of having children. Now, I'm actually not sure if I want to marry our 14-year-old daughter off to him because, like I say, she has a really good intrigue stat. I think she's going to make a great spy master, so I might actually keep her in our court and just to see what happens there. But we can actually marry off one of our 11-year-old daughters. So she's got the beauty trait, so I think she will be the best one to marry off to him. And we're going to hope that once they obviously get married, they can have some sons. Because one thing that will happen, of course, is when Bjorn does die, Sweden's going to be broken up between his sons. So these three here will end up getting the titles of Sweden. So I think the best candidate is going to be Bjorn's son. So like I say, get our daughter married off to him, and then hopefully we can keep some good ties with Sweden. Because obviously, you know, even though Sweden's going to be broken up, we still don't want them to turn their attention to us, because that's going to give us a lot of problems. And then what we got this place here. Now, his primary heir is actually this girl here. Now, I'm thinking we could possibly make something happen here. One option that we got is we could try and abduct her. And then once we get her into our prison, we can make her our concubine. We're going to try an abduction scheme on her and see if we can get that to pay off. Now, obviously, it's only 26%, but hopefully we can improve that with recruiting some agents. As I mentioned last episode a lot, we have got to watch our money, though, because we're running out quite swiftly. Unfortunately, we can only get one agent for 19, which won't even take that past 50%. So that's going to be a problem. Now, I think we've already got our spymaster helping us, and we just have to see what we can do. Now, one thing I did want to look at is I'm pretty sure last time we was looking at a princess over in Francia or West Francia. And I'm not really sure what happened to her. So we do want to check that out, see what's going down there. Now, the primary heir is this guy here. He actually hasn't got any children. I can't really see any options down here. We can also check, say, Brittany. Again, can't really see anything. King's wife's already in prison. He's quite old now, so he's going to be going. So the player will be this guy. Now, the trouble is, because of our religion, we won't be able to marry any of our daughters off to this guy, because a different faith causes it to be -1,000. So getting that over the line is going to be pretty much impossible. And then one thing while doing this we have to note is that we can't actually change the faith of somebody that has titles. So we have to try and get them in before they get any titles. There's this little place to lose popped up. The trouble is that I don't really think that's going to last. I think they're going to take that out pretty quickly. So I don't think it's worth making any moves there. Barcelona's actually been taken by West Francia. When the kings die of these places, they get broken up so much, it's difficult to tell where each part's going to go. Then we look over at England, and we can't really see too many plays there. But I think with these two plays that we've got going at the moment, I think they will be good for now. Now, one thing I do want to do is I want to just check out our court chaplain, because we do have to get a different court chaplain, because, I mean, 11 is just pitiful, to be honest. So we're going to try and sort that out. And of course, the one way we can do that is we can try and marry one of our knights off to somebody. Like this girl, for example, she has 21, and I mean, she has 44. I always try and get them in as young as they can, because then they obviously last longer. But she does have the Mastermind Philosopher, which is good. And now she's in, now we can just switch her religion over, and then she will automatically join our cult. All right, we've got one agent joining our scheme, which is good. Can we actually get that up in anymore? We got it 45. That's not enough, is it? We have our spy master helping us on our schemes. Now, because we have two schemes running, does that make these percentages lower on what our spy master can do? Because if our spy master's helping us on both, you know, it might mean they can't actually work as hard on one scheme. So if we only had them working on one scheme, maybe that will help with the percentages. Oh, and one thing I should mention is that if you're not subscribed, then make sure you subscribe, because then YouTube will keep you up to date on when I release a new episode. You can also hit the notification so you get notified of when that episode comes out. Right, so we will get this woman in as our new court chaplain, and that takes that from 11 to 21. See if we can get a better steward. And what we got here, so we got a 20, we got a 20, we got a 19. Now this guy does have Midas touched, which is good, so I think we're going to go for him. This dratted child has been lying in wait around corners wearing a wolf skin for a costume, only to jump out screaming and scaring the living daylights out of people. Bloody kids. Now why would you punish him? Come on now. We're just going to say that. I mean, you know, what's the harm? It's just a kid, he's just having fun, isn't he? Like, just let him do his thing. So Inga. Oh, Inga, the mother of three of our children. That's not our child, is it? No. Her husband has died, because I'm pretty sure she did have one, but he's now gone. I mean, see if we can get a better chancellor. I mean, 17 already, which isn't too bad. And then, like I say, we have got our daughter to come in to be our spy master. Now, we could get this guy. I mean, he's quite beastly in that department. But I just, I don't know. I kind of prefer the idea of getting our daughter in, because, you know, it's always good to keep your children close to you, because it's going to be easier to keep decent relationships with them. Yeah, he's got grey eminence, so he's going to be a good selection. And she gets a husband as well, you know, keeps her happy. My nephew Joel Nudd is a complicated man. I need to understand him as well as possible if I'm to convince people to take my side in any upcoming arguments. So this is our hook scheme against our nephew, and 93% chance is pretty darn good, so hopefully we get that. So he finds you out, that's not good. See, what we could do is possibly get a hook on this guy, then when we go to here we can use bribe or we can use hook, and we can hopefully get him on our team. But yeah, we'll have to see. Right, okay, so our hook on this guy, can we get one? Yeah, we can. We get a weak hook, which isn't great. I mean, it's gonna cost us 150 prestige. We'll take it. We will take that, because, oh, our brother died, it just said. Okay, so she's 11, and we do have a 10-year-old son, Ragnar. So we're going to actually marry, if we got her opinion of us, up to 100. I think we'll be able to do that. So, can we sway her? No, we can send her a gift. How much? 31. Yeah, I think we can do the 31. Now they would accept it. So we'll do that. We'll get him married off to her, and then hopefully we can start taking over this bit of land here. These have actually gone down. Worries me. So success chance 58, so I'm guessing it would be a good idea to get a hook on this guy then, but I don't understand why they've changed. I'm hoping that doesn't happen again, because if I get a hook on this guy and then it changes. Oh, so hold on, this is the spouse of her. Right, I see. Yeah, so we get a hook on this guy, and then hopefully we can get him to help us. He will be a really good person to get on board, because he's going to be close to her. Right, so now we've got a good court chaplain. I'm now going to get a claim on this bit of land here. So we'll build that claim up, and then once that comes in, we can try and take over this bit of land here. Obviously, the plan now is to try and just take over these little places here, and then try and take all of this part of Norway. And then we can start heading this way. But in the meantime, while we're taking these, we're trying to take this bit of land by, you know, marriages, hooks, stuff like that. So hopefully that all plays out. So it said my brother died, so that means Bjorn is now dead. We did predict this coming, and fortunately we've actually got our daughter in there just in time. But as you can see now, Sweden's been broken up into two main parts really, and a couple of little places. Bjorn's son is still the king of Sweden, and then this guy has taken the other part. Now I can't actually see any plays that we can make with this guy, so we just have to wait and see what happens there. But once these two are married, we will get the alliance back with Bjorn's son, so that'd be good. The one thing I didn't think about is the hook on this guy is going to take longer than the abduct scheme on this girl. So we might have to delay this one and then get the hook on him first. But yeah, we'll see how that goes. Ideally, obviously, I should have got, you know, the hook on him first before I tried to abduct her. Everything's easy in hindsight, right? Now, this is because our son's betrothed to her, so that's all good. She's agreed. go ahead when... I mean, it's going to be a while. They've got, like, what, 5 years to go. Now, what is this? Fight him? Oh, I don't want to fight him. He's, like, 23. He's a beast of a man. I think I'm going to go for this one, because this one just... I mean, that's way too much stress. 80 stress is crazy. But this is 71% chance that he gains our cult. Plus, we get prestige. Yeah, we'd take this one. Fortunately, we get it. He does join our cult. So, we've actually got a really good champion there, which is good. Mental break. Fortunately, we've got a journal. And our stress is building up a lot. Yeah, we're at 203 now. She's been released from prison. I mean, she's getting absolutely annihilated down there. She's got this little place down here. Okay, this is our hook. So we will get that hook, hopefully. I'm kind of hoping she doesn't have any children in the time being. Because obviously the child that she has first, if it's a son, it will be the heir because she's the current heir. And then if she has a son, that son will then be the heir. So we're kind of hoping that doesn't happen. But we will see. Call to war. Bjorn's son wants us to go to war with him. He's got 2,000. He's got 1,000. What's Bjorn got? 3,000. Okay. I mean, add our troops to that. He's going to have like 5,000 troops. So he should be able to defend it. Okay. Okay, we're coming to help you again, by the way, Bjorn, son. We helped your dad out last time. So this is, you're starting to make a habit of it. I don't like it. You know, you need to learn how to fight your own battles. So where is this battle going on? Over here. Yeah, so he's trying to take over some land over there. Like I say, as long as he's going this way, I am happy. As long as he's not coming this way towards us. Right, so we'll start moving across. Okay, so now this is the abduction thing. Now the thing is that I'm going to delay this because it's 44% chance and we've got 46% chance we're going to be discovered. So I'm not going to attempt it and I'm just going to leave it to run again. Because then hopefully we can get this hook on him and then invite him to be an agent in the scheme. Who is this woman here? Ooh, 23, and she has the genius trait. But she is a lunatic. No, just get rid of her. She must burn for her crimes. Yeah. Sorry, love, but, you know, you're a lunatic. We can't risk getting any of that. Okay, and this is our claim. Yep, see it done. Get the claim sorted. Okay, what is this about? Right, this is for the hook, and we actually get a strong hook on him. Yeah, we're going to go for it. Act of tyranny, but... we're going to get him added to this ASAP. Here he is. Use our hook. He will help us. And then that bumps it up to 85%. So that is huge. Oh, he was the guy we released from prison, wasn't it? Right, we can abandon that now. We don't need that going. Because it's already 100%. Right, so let's go and attach ourselves to one of Bjorn's armies. One of our daughters. And she is the spy master. So we're going to get her in. She's actually going to take her mother's place. So we've attached them to Bjorn's son's army. And then he can just do with them whatever he wants, whatever he needs. Hopefully work it out. Right, let's put this spy master in. It's actually her daughter, which is good. Inga's her mum. They actually look really similar. Look at her face. Look at her face. They're like twins. Right, so with my agents coming and going freely at the court, Inga is within reach. Another Inga. Okay, 85% chance. We've done a lot for this to happen, so hopefully it works. Hopefully it all pays off. But we're going to go for it. 85%. I like the look of that. Let's do it.
Ladies and gentlemen.
We got her. Nice.
We got him.
Nice, nice, nice. She hasn't had any children either, which is great news. And now what we're going to do is we're going to make her our concubine. So she is now our concubine. So hopefully we can have a child with her. And then if we look at her parent, there obviously is a chance that she could still have a child. Once we've changed her religion, we want to be looking at murdering him then. So I guess the first thing we need to do is fabricate a hook on her. If she actually takes over, before we get that hook, we won't be able to change her religion. So we need to move swiftly on that.